Hi, I'm Joel from Microsoft. At Microsoft, we operate on the principle of zero standing access. That means our personnel, by default, does not have standing access to customer data. When just in time or temporary access is granted, it's the bare minimum, meaning our experts have the minimum access and time required to complete the task. There are three categories of accounts within Office 365 to support our mission: service team accounts or privileged accounts, service accounts, and customer accounts. Service team accounts, also known as privileged accounts, are used by individual team personnel to manage Office 365. Access rights are granted using role-based access control to meet separation of duties requirements. Service accounts are used by Office 365 services to authenticate to servers and other services. These accounts cannot be accessed by Microsoft personnel. Finally, customer accounts are just that, accounts used by our customers to access Office 365. Customer accounts are managed by the customer, either by a federated model with a customer's on-premise Active Directory infrastructure, or with a cloud identity model using Azure Active Directory managed accounts. Let's take a deep dive into how Microsoft manages service team accounts. At Microsoft, we've automated account management tools allowing service teams to track the process through account request, approval, creation, modification, and deletion. Additionally, these tools notify managers and automatically revoke access of an employee when there are internal transfers or employment terminations, or the employee fails to complete mandated training. Our account management tools automatically disable accounts after the period of inactivity and locks accounts when the maximum number of unsuccessful login attempts is exceeded. In addition, automated auditing of these accounts is enabled. It's also important to note that Microsoft does not allow the use of shared or group accounts. Office 365 has implemented personnel screening controls that include the use of background checks on employees and contingent staff as permitted by local law, prior to authorizing access to the information system. It is also important to note that certain roles supporting cloud offerings may involve additional background checks or authentication requirements. What about remote access? Office 365 only authorizes remote access after approval from an authorized manager. Because Office 365 service teams do not have physical access to Microsoft's data centers, there is a business requirement for those personnel to have remote access. Each service team personnel is assigned a role within their service team that corresponds to a security group. Security groups are assigned permissions to correlating environments with just enough access to properly fulfill their tasks. It is important to note that default access to environments does not provide any elevated permissions. So, let's talk about the concept of least privilege. Office 365 service teams employ this concept, which only allows authorized access for service team users or processes acting on behalf of service team users that are necessary to accomplish assigned tasks in accordance with business functions and organizational needs. The use of the JIT, or just-in-time access model, ensures that service teams only ever have the necessary access required to support the operation of Office 365 and are restricted by elevation level, resource access, and time. One of the tools allowing privileged access to the Office 365 production environment is Lockbox. Exchange Online, Exchange Online Protection, and SharePoint Online are some of the service teams which use Lockbox for elevated access. So, who controls access in this scenario? The access approver reviews and, based on business need, approves or denies the request. Access is granted for a finite period of time based on the expected duration of the task. Lastly, once access is approved, Lockbox assigns the service team user to security groups with the minimum permissions required to perform the work and automatically revokes those permissions at the end of the specified time period. Reviews of all accounts and approved access occur regularly. No one has standing access to customer data in Office 365, period. However, in rare incidents when it is absolutely required, service engineers may be granted temporary access with just enough allotted time to complete the task at hand. In these instances, we implement a rigorous and highly supervised process to request permissions. For customers concerned about Microsoft personnel accessing customer data content in SharePoint, Exchange, and OneDrive, they can license and provision an additional access approval feature called Customer Lockbox. Let's take a look at how Customer Lockbox works. If an engineer is working with a customer to troubleshoot an issue, it needs access to customer data. The first step is to ask the customer to open a ticket with Microsoft. These requests are sent to a high-level manager at Microsoft, who examines it carefully, deciding to approve or deny the request using multi-factor authentication. Upon approval, the request is sent to the customer's designated Lockbox approver for review and final approval. Only if the customer approves the request can Microsoft get access to the customer data. The access is automatically revoked after the time assigned to complete the troubleshooting operation expires. It becomes part of a logged, auditable record. If the customer does not reject or approve the request, then after a period of time, it will expire without Microsoft gaining access to the customer content. It's important to reiterate Microsoft's commitment to the principle of zero standing administrative privileges and zero standing access to customer data in Office 365. Microsoft engineers will only ever have limited, audited, and secured access to customer data for a short period of time during service operations and only when approved by a member of Microsoft management. We believe that operating with the principle of zero standing access to customer data is key to effectively keeping your data safe. Thank you for watching, and additional papers and guidance can be found on the Service Trust Portal.